I'm just dropping off your food.
Leave it on the table.
Looking for something on Netflix can be frustrating, but I'm here to ease your angst with a simplified list of the best Netflix originals. I'm Emily, and here are the top 8 of 2018 so far. But first, make sure to subscribe, and after this video, check out all our comprehensive coverage of the new season of Westworld. For now, this list has something for every choosy Netflix binger's taste, from sci-fi to anime, starting off with a dark comedy. Originally airing on British television, The End of the F***ing World was a co-production with Netflix and came to the streaming service in early 2018. The 8-part series follows a 17-year-old named James who believes that he's a psychopath. He kills animals for fun, but wants to try his hand at killing a human and decides to murder Alyssa, who wants to run away from home. Get ready for a demented adventure. I should warn you that this series is dark and not for the faint of heart, but their journey is incredibly engaging. If you're looking for a dark comedy, this will definitely hit the spot. If dystopian science fiction with a dash of cyberpunk is up your alley, then Altered Carbon is your ideal sci-fi. This series, which takes place 350 years in the future, follows a former political operative who wakes up after being asleep for 250 years. After the long hibernation, he is tasked with solving the murder of a wealthy man. The story and tech involved with it all gets extremely complex, but I'll just leave it at that, as I don't want to give away too much. Over the course of 2 years, a documentary crew followed Flint, Michigan's police department. What they saw in the city was an understaffed and underfunded department trying to do its best. A few years prior, Flint had 300 officers, but now they're down to 98 and only have a few patrol cars. There's an inkling of hope as the series moves forward, but there's always bumps in the road. Unfortunately, Flint was put in the spotlight in 2014 with the Flint water crisis, which was a public health violation that took an enormous toll on the city's residents. Flint Town is one of the best produced Netflix original docuseries. Netflix pumps out a ton of original programming geared at children, but most of it's unwatchable for the whole family. Luckily, there are a few shows that both parents and their kids can enjoy, or that single folk can enjoy without kids. The second season of A Series of Unfortunate Events is wonderfully fun and quirky, and can be exceptionally dark in tone. At times, the show is repetitive, but its quick, witty humor, along with Neil Patrick Harris's performance of Olaf, will make you completely forget about that. Continuing down the family-friendly path, the new Lost in Space reboot is definitely worth binging. But with this modern twist also comes a new kind of not-so-family-friendly fandom that could only exist on the internet. Apparently, this show stimulated a bit of a robot butt fetish on Twitter. In response to all the derriere comments left on their Twitter account, Netflix posted, "Y'all need Jesus." But the family shouldn't be overshadowed by Will Robinson's bootylicious protector. The cast does a nice job of depicting this modern version of the Robinson family on their way to colonize another planet with other humans. But when the ship comes under attack, the Robinsons hop into an escape craft and become lost in space. Ugly Delicious has found a formula to stand out from the rest of the travel shows, by delivering a strong message while simultaneously dining on delicious food. The series follows Chef David Chang as he dives into the history of food and its importance to its respective culture and all of society. The first season, which consists of 8 episodes, is fantastic. And what makes this a standout series is that each one takes such an in-depth look at individual food items, from Chinese food and American perspectives on the cuisine as a whole, to fried chicken, which delves into its racial history in the US and how the rest of the world prepares it. Ugly Delicious is much more than a show about people eating food. The 6-part Netflix series Wild Wild Country documents the Rodneesh movement and their move to the United States during the early 80s. At the time, the group bought a large plot of land in rural Oregon, built a city, and tried to infiltrate the local government, which included assassination attempts and poisoning residents. It's an unsettling and bizarre tale which is masterfully told by Chapman Way and McLean Way. What sets it apart from others in its genre is that it lets both sides tell their own story. We hear from those involved in the Rodneesh movement, as well as those who lived in the nearby town of Antelope, which had a population of 60, who had fears of more than 7,000 people moving into their town. The story itself is so crazy that you'll find yourself fact-checking everything, and your jaw will drop when you realize it's all true. Agretzuko is based on one of the newest characters from Hello Kitty company Sanrio. The lovable main character Retzko is an average office worker with a relentlessly reliable work ethic that often leaves her mistreated by her lazy coworkers and her controlling chauvinistic boss. He's a narcissistic pig who sweats profusely and fixates on golf. Why does that sound familiar? The timely character is an obvious pun that works well for the anime, and makes the show that much more relatable for anyone who struggles with their daily grind. Tsunoda, a self-serving deer with an infectious laugh and sparkle in her eye, is one of the most adorably annoying antagonists in anime. Don't let the twinkle in her eye fool you. To deal with pent-up anger after a long day working beside Tsunoda, her boss, and the rest of her annoying coworkers, Retsuko's outlet is karaoke. And not just any karaoke. She only sings heavy death metal that gives her an outlet to rage against her suffocating corporate workplace. Each episode is 15 minutes of pure angsty bliss. Obviously, some of the shows on this list are ones you're already familiar with, but there are plenty of series that went under the radar as well. If you need any more suggestions, check out our video on what to watch on Netflix in June for all your Netflix needs. Thanks for watching.